Milk for Health presents the Western New York Youth in Ag Bonanza, live to you at home, where youth from the 8 counties of Western New York will compete in livestock judging and showmanship in various categories. Live from the Showplex on the Erie County Fairgrounds in Hamburg, New York, Milk for Health presents the Western New York Youth in Ag Bonanza.
Hang on. There we go. John DeShula with you with Larry Thurber. And we are back at the Showplex for the Western New York Youth in Ag Bonanza. And this is the English Showmanship. What are we looking at for performance and trail, Larry?
This is our English equitation class. And this means how are they riding their horse in English style. Earlier you saw their clothing. Now you're going to see how they ride in this English style.
And the English style, based on the clothing, as you mentioned, this kind
yes.
of almost like a fox hunt kind of look.
Yes.
And the pith helmet look.
Yes. High boots, breeches, conservative jackets.
Legs over each side of the animal.
Yep.
Not side saddle.
Yep. But the clothing for right now is there's a purpose for all of that. The high boots, in case you're in tacky ground, you know, brushes and briars. This choker around your neck, if your horse gets hurt, that choker comes off, and you can wrap it around a leg. Breeches are for comforting riding in whatever territory you're getting at.
So there's a purpose in
yes.
addition to the look.
Yes.
And that look is consistent.
And then you get to the horse, and this type of riding can lead to anything over fences or, in that manner, or fox hunting. Again, there is a pleasure-type horse. He's not a stock horse. His head is up, his tail's up. Straight across, a chestnut horse with white legs. This is an Arab. There's a stock horse on the inside at number 60. So now what are we looking for?
Well, yeah, what are we looking for? Because in my notes here it says it's the art or practice of horse or riding.
Yes.
In showmanship.
Currently in the ring is heat one of our senior English equitation. There will be two heats in this class.
And it looks like the
on
rider
the rail
is
at
upright.
The walk. Please walk.
Yes. So what obviously.
Now they've just been asked to walk.
Yes. They're going to walk, trot, and canter in this class both ways, and they should back. But the position of your body will also allow your horse to understand what you want it to do. I was looking for number 10. You look at the exhibitor's shoulder,
uh-huh.
and you drop a line from the shoulder to their hip. And from the exhibitor's hip, and from the exhibitor's hip
on
to their heel.
On the rail at the canter, please. All canter.
Her heel, her hip, her shoulder in a nice alignment.
So we saw them come out. Were they trotting when they
yes.
first came out? And then
yes.
they walked. Now it's cantering.
Yes.
What is a cantering? What is the movement? What does that mean?
A trot is a two-beat gait, opposite legs going forward at the same time. A canter is like a three-beat gait. It's
yeah, you can
stronger
almost hear it.
Than
one,
a trot.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, and then a little halt, and then 1, 2, 3, and a little halt.
And the horse is trained to trot, walk, and canter.
Yes.
On the rail at the walk, all walk.
Yes,
please.
And there again is transitions up, like we saw in showmanship, and transitions down. So when
please reverse at
the judge
walk.
Looks
reverse
at their
at the
shoulder,
walk.
Hip, and heel, then he looks to see if from the bit of the horse, which is in the horse's mouth, to the hands of the rider, to the shoulder, if it's kind of a straight line. And we don't want, you can have a slight incline on your shoulders at the trot.
On the rail at the canter, please, all canter.
Okay, the other thing about a canter, all these horses, that chestnut horse in the middle, that red horse in the middle, the front leg to the inside is first, and that's called the right lead.
The right leg is moving before the left.
Yes.
Yep.
Yes.
I just noticed that on one of the entrants.
Yes.
And we should go through the list of entrants here, and we're splitting this up into 10 entrants.
Okay.
And that's in the performance and trail, Alyssa Graziano from Forestville. Her horse is Valbella, that's entrant number 5. Elena Endres, entrant number 10, her animal is Cybotage. Liana Elliott, entrant 17. The horse is She's Ritzy. Emma Siplicki. Emma Siplicki, number 31, with So Magical, from Holland, New York. Samantha Logan from Eden, New York, number 60, her animal Who's Perfect. Eliza Schrantz, entrant 65, the animal Zipson's Betty Bright. Eliza's from Jerry, New York. Emily Wyskowski, entrant 67 from Boston, New York, with her horse Yucca Poco Bonanza. Brianna Myers is entrant number number 94 from East Aurora, her animal Paintress Kelly. Erin Hayes, entrant number 119 from Holland, New York, her animal Song and a Prayer. And Gabrielle Marchetti, entrant 125 from Lockport, New York, and don't have a name for her horse. So those are the exhibitors that are in the showmanship, performance, and trail. When it says trail, what does that mean, Larry? Why do we say trail?
Later on, we'll have trail classes, which will be a number of obstacles, and the horse will have to go through them at a walk, a trot, or a canter. And each obstacle, there again, you get...
Come into the ring and wind up after trot, facing the warm-up pen.
There again, in the trail class, it's how well you go over each maneuver.
So, Judge Duke Digert, right now, what is the judge looking for? Because he's watching each animal before in the other shows we had one animal at a time.
Right now, this particular class is split.
We'd like to remind all of our exhibitors, please be sure to use social distancing as you line up in the ring as well as along ringside and in the warm-up ring.
Means he would this class performed and he'll take X number of horses.
Currently
out of this
in the ring is our first split of Senior English Act. Split two of our Senior English Act, please be ready at ringside.
So then he'll bring in another group and take so many horses from that group. Then his third group, he'll make his winners, take his winners from. And if you've noticed, some of these horses back, some of these horses back nicely, some of them hesitate. And just like in the showmanship, you want
to
play it straight, not crooked.
We will be using the far gate over by the awards area to exit the ring for all classes today on the rail. For our classes that have splits, if you make it back for the split, please exit out the exit gate and head back into the warm-up pen.
So the thing about this, you're not mandated how many you ask to come back. You might bring four back, you might bring five back. Some of the breed shows, you'll be mandated to bring like four back. My personally one, we had five cuts of 20 each. We had to bring four back from each five, so our final cut was 20 horses. And this is a nice little story because there's three judges, and we all brought the same horses back except one judge brought an odd horse in because it looked pretty, and he was searching in the last minute. But... And it was just a wonderful time to think that we would all pick the same four horses out of five cuts.
That's an interesting point, Larry. Does a judge see something different you would see versus, say, Duke Digert or another judge?
Yes. And that's, like, this particular class is on equitation, but you still have to have your horses performing the way they should perform.
Yeah.
And it's not a fault and out class. But if you make a fault, you better correct it quietly and nicely.
Coming back to compete in our final round in our Senior English Equitation will be back number 10, Elena Endress of Hamburg, New York. Back number 60, Samantha Logan of Eden, New York. Back number 65, Eliza Schranz of Gary, New York. Back number 67, Emily Witkowski of Boston, New York. Back number 119, Erin Hayes of Holland, New York. And back number 125, Gabrielle Marchetti of Lockport, New York. Congratulations to all of our riders in this class. You are now excused, and we will bring in split two of our Senior English Act.
And that's a nice number to bring back, because if he picks six out of the next class, he'll have a class of 12 for final.
Yeah.
And that way, like I said, it's not a fault in our class. But your horse really should, maybe in pleasure we'll talk about it a little more, but he needs to come in and perform his duties while you're looking pretty.
Well, Elena Endress was number one in everything there from Hamburg with her entrant, Sabotage. We're going to take a quick break here, Larry Thurber, from the Showplex.
Make me healthy, stronger, please.
Milk times three is good for me. Milk times three is good for me. Milk times three is good for me.
The Erie County Fairgrounds in Hamburg, New York. One of the Northeast's premier agriculture and entertainment destinations. Home to the Erie County Fair, the Fairgrounds Event Center, Buffalo Raceway, Hamburg Gaming, and host to nationally recognized livestock, ag industry shows, and award-winning ag education programs. Annually, the state-of-the-art Agriculture Discovery Center and Choplex buildings attract thousands of participants and their livestock for events like the Empire State Beef Classic, the Spring Dairy Preview, and the National Junior Swine Association Eastern Regional Hog Show. Located near Buffalo and the U.S.-Canadian border, the Erie County Fairgrounds is a convenient drive from points across the East. Where competitors and champions grow, we'll see you soon at the Erie County Fairgrounds in Hamburg, New York.
All right, we're back at the Showplex, the Fairgrounds at Erie County. And lovely to see the promotional piece there for the fair. We're back, Larry, and I'm going to go through the names of the entrants so that we can make sure everybody who's watching gets a chance to have their loved one acknowledged. Jessica Nickerson is entrant 135 from Orchard Park. Her horse's name is Flame. Megan Stang, entrant 167 from Perrysburg with Lady Paradise. Taylor Finnerty, entrant 189 with her horse I'm All Good. Taylor Grover, entrant 191 from Cheektowaga. The animal is SHF.
On the rail at the canter, please all canter.
SHF made from scratch. Brianna Warner is entrant 214 with the flashy invitation. Jillian Buchert, entrant 250 with her animal ABD, Jake of Diamonds. A few more, Maggie Knoll, entrant 264 from East Aurora with her horse Dakota Fire Eclipse. Samantha Syracuse, entrant 280 from Alden, New York, with Good Luck Charlie. Sarah Cox is entrant 282 with Awesome Artist from Warsaw. And Taylor Bentley, 283 from Buffalo, New York. Her animal's name is Harley. You don't see too many entrants from Buffalo, but that said, you can be from anywhere and still connect with a horse at a barn in an area where the horses are able
on
to
the rail
live and
at
thrive.
The walk. Please all walk.
And with this day and age, many horses are boarded. They're not kept at their owner's home anymore. And it's nice when you have a place that you can board that have similar interests, have people of your own age group, and it makes a whole different setup than if you have it by yourself. And it's an opportunity to learn more.
Reverse
to hear how
and
other
continue
people are doing
to walk.
Things.
Please reverse and continue to walk.
And in this particular class, we've got some very nice riders and having their horse do what needs to be done. And
currently in the ring is our second heat of Senior English Equitation. After this class, we will bring back those from both of our heats to compete for your top five Senior English Ec.
So in Senior English Equitation.
Yes.
And equitation, a new word that I've learned this week.
Excellent. How pretty you look riding that horse.
Well, I wouldn't look
on
very pretty at all.
On the rail at the canter,
yes,
please. All canter.
So we're watching what we saw with the other exhibitors. They're trotting, they're walking, they're cantering, and they did a turn. Well, not a turn so much, but they went the other way.
Yes, we have to reverse. And different breeds and different organizations have different ways for you to reverse. At 4-H, to my knowledge, at this time, it's still you can reverse either way. Something else you'll see in this English classes and some of the Western, some of the pads have it so you can have their numbers on the pads and you can see it from the side. Other people have them on the center of their back. And 4-H is a place to get started in your horsemanship career. So there's no sense in spending lots and lots of money, you know. But if you can get a pad at a tack swap or something, that you can have their numbers on the side of the horse, it's so much easier for the person judging in the center. Especially the class like now. There's 10 horses here.
We're watching Judge Duke Diger.
Down to the trot, please. All trot.
Duke looking at each horse in each entrant. Now we're trotting around the showplex.
Right. And here's a good example of a judge watching what's happening in the arena. There was a horse that wasn't quite doing what it should do, and it was going to get other horses in trouble.
How did you see that?
Out of the corner of my eye.
Yeah, I don't know how you see it, Larry.
And he said trot, which allowed everybody to get themselves back and organized and not worried about getting in trouble.
What was the animal doing that indicated there could be trouble on the horizon?
Well, he was on the wrong lead and stopping and standing and starting to back up a little bit and hump his back. But now he's straightened out. There's no sense in... That's the thing about it. When you judge, sometimes you have to have a naughty box on your page.
Please trot into the middle and line up facing the warm-up arena.
If they do something like kick and buck and run off, you really got to put them in the naughty box because they can reverse and have the best go ever, and you almost might use them, but they were naughty.
So it happens with horses.
Yes, it does.
You get sent to the naughty box.
Okay. Yeah, and...
Happens to us all, Larry.
The naughty box for all of us.
Duke Diggert, he has that look, doesn't he? He looks like the horse judge that, you know, with that mustache. Just a wonderful guy. He was with us last week and a great family.
We'd like to remind all exhibitors and spectators that we do have food trailers available outside of the showplex. They will be here all day for you, so please be sure to patronize them. They are located outside of the showplex.
Well, and him and his wife, Barb, they had horses in 4-H and youth, and they grew up in that. And then they had an opportunity to get the farm with produce and all of that.
Yeah, Bippert's.
Yep, absolutely. And he went on to get his NRHA, which is National Riding Horse Judges card. And it's wonderful. The people of Western New York from a long time ago have used their skills and went on with them and developed and used it for a life.
Now he's pointing to the horse and so the exhibitor, the rider, then makes the move for the horse to go backwards or make the move. Okay.
Because what he's doing is making sure the other horse is out of the way.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Interesting to see and
lot
to look at.
Each person does it just a little different, you know.
It's amazing, and he has to be so fair. And so thorough. I noticed in other judging categories, the judge would take their time, sometimes bringing the animal and the exhibitor back, to go that extra length to make sure that they got their just due, because, as we've said, there haven't been any shows, and these exhibitors have been working long hours and long weeks and months to get to this point.
And it's only fair of you as the evaluator that you give every exhibitor time. The days of 100 horses in a halter class have kind of gone by.
Is this about the number of horses you would see in a show like this, or are we reducing it because of the situation that we're in?
I think this is
coming back to compete in your final of the Senior English Eck will be back number 167, Megan Stang, back number 214, Brianna Warner, back number 250, Jillian Buckert, back number 264, Maggie Knoll, and back number 282, Sarah Cox. Congratulations to all of those riders in this class. At this time, you are now excused. If you are staying for the final heat, please exit out of the exit gate and come back into the warm-up pen, and we will bring those riders back in to compete for your final top five in the Senior English Act.
Well, in answer to your question, it kind of goes both ways. With our COVID, a lot of people don't want to get out, and other people are just itching to go, and like here we're having our restrictions and our 6 feet apart and washing our hands and our mask, and so they're willing to come. And this is a nice size show, but at one point in time this would be one county's worth of show.
Wow.
Plus more juniors, plus more, and the fact that it's five counties, it's a nice weekend. It's pleasant. It's handable.
It very is a nice weekend. We're going to give the names here of some of the people you just heard. Megan Stang was number one. from Perrysburg with Lady Paradise. Number two is Brianna Warner with De Flashy Invitation. Number three, Jillian Buechert. You know what we're going to do, Larry? We're going to take a quick break while they're bringing in the next bunch of horses, and then we'll be back in a minute right after this.
Sounds good.
On behalf of all your Western New York dairy farmers, we assure you that our job has not changed. We are still caring for our animals as we do every day, and we are still producing a clean and healthy product that you can feel safe serving to your families. All the dairy products that reach your table are also on our own family table, never touched by human hands, and from the farm to the grocery store within 48 hours, 365 days a year, through calm or chaos. We promise.
We are back at the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, with Larry Thurber. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the next bunch in, and this is a senior English equitation as well.
Yes, this will be the two sets of splits, and this will be our final go, and our winners will be selected from this section.
Yeah, so with this group that's here, we are in the junior, am I right, with the juniors?
No, this is
the senior?
Senior still, class five, senior equitation.
Okay.
We split it twice, and then we take four from one, five from another.
Oh, that's
this
right.
This is the final go.
This is the final go from the horses that we selected.
Yes. So now we will pick a winner from this nice big class.
So the best of the first split and the best of the second split.
Yes.
Okay.
And if you notice, again, going back to the stock horse and the pleasure horse, we have both in here. And even though you're supposed to have that shoulder, hip, heel, you just look just a little bit
please
different.
Please canter, all canter.
There's a pleasure horse here that kind of throws her up a little bit, moves really pretty, catches your eye. A couple stock horses that really catches your eye.
And there they are, and it looks like one horse kind of cut across a little bit.
Yes.
Is that something that was acceptable? Or?
Well, if it means not cutting off another horse, it is acceptable.
Okay.
If you're doing it just because you're going too fast, then it's like, uh-oh, slow down, girl, slow down.
Do they have to follow in order, or does that matter so much?
No, it does not, because every horse is of a different speed. Here we have this little paint horse coming up. He's right on the corner.
Down to the trot.
He's right where he needs to be. He's never out of... He's got his own little bubble. He's riding in his own little bubble. And we have a nice little Arab who's just a nice strided little horse. But when he comes around, he's just a little faster than someone like that paint
horse. Those of you joining us ringside, this is our final class in our senior English act. On deck will be junior English act.
Lovely class. Mr. Diger is definitely earning his money today.
Yep. Final
please
class.
Please reverse at the trot. Reverse at the trot.
And this is nice because we didn't talk about diagonals with English. When you ride, the simple way is when you're rising out of your saddle, you should be rising.
When you say rising out of the saddle, meaning the exhibitor who's riding
yes,
the horse?
Yes, the exhibitor's rising out of that saddle. See how he's rising? She's riding on a saddle. The easiest way for me to describe this is she should be going up with the outside leg, outside front leg. Outside front leg, she's going up. That's the easiest way to describe it.
And which leg leads you on that, left or right?
The horse is right, left front, the one that's on the rail. Technically.
Very important to sit up straight.
Very important. This
on the rail at the walk, please walk.
So now they're walking.
Yeah. It, I said at the trot, you can lean a slight bit forward. At the canter, you can lean a slight bit forward as well, just because it's a forward motion. The other part of this is...
All canter, please, on the rail at the canter.
We'll see later. We'll see extended trots. We'll see hand gallops. In this type of riding, there's also something called a two-point. You would actually get up so your knees are holding each horse and your bum's out of the saddle, and you'd be ready to jump over a rail, cross rail, or a small fence. And those are something that he could call here if he wanted to.
Will we see jumping in our English showmanship
today?
Not this show. I've seen that in other horse shows, with the fence, the little fences.
Yes.
Are out on the arena.
Yes, and you can have something called Hunter Hack, which is they see how your horse performs over the crowd, and they only do two fences. And those fences have to be like 48 to 60 feet apart.
Down
it's
to
your
the trot,
beginning
please,
jumping,
all
beginning
trot.
Jumping.
Okay, so now we're all trotting again.
Please
Sorry.
Trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen. Please trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen.
And now they're going to come back.
On deck will be Junior English Equitation in the hole. We will be looking for Novice English Equitation.
The numbers he picks now will be the winners of this class.
The winners in the senior
yes.
English Equitation.
Yes. And something else I forgot to mention. We have something called three-day events into one day and things, which is jumping, dressage, cross-country jumping.
What is dressage?
Dressage is maneuvers for your horse. There's different patterns that you have to run. It's individually run, and you're scored at individual maneuvers. And it's a specific way of riding your horse. And a specific saddle and bridle and whips. And so these horses can be used for many different activities other than just this particular show. If you chose to go that way.
Reminder to all exhibitors, we will be taking a 20-minute lunch break at noon. Once again, at noon, we will be taking a 20-minute lunch break. A reminder that the trail course is open for all of those that would like to go practice in the livestock arena. We do not have a separate trail judge, so we will be doing trail at the conclusion of the road hack classes.
So the judge is looking, Duke Digert and his assistant.
Mm-hmm.
Kirby Digert at the announce booth as we listen to her make these various announcements. You just heard that we're going to have a lunch break around noon. If you're watching, it's just before 11:15 on Friday, August 21st, as you're watching our live web stream from West New York or across the country. Or maybe you're watching the posted feed and taking a look at your loved one who's exhibiting here today. We congratulate everybody who is participating and thank you for your diligence and patience this year. And a hats off to the staff at the Erie County Fairgrounds and Erie County Agricultural Society, CEO Jessica Underberg and her team. Very diligent to work on this. You see Duke? Duke looks like a movie actor, doesn't he? He could have been in Rawhide, I think, Duke Digert.
Yes, he could have been.
Every Saturday afternoon at 3, just before Beat the Champ, there he would be. Riding along.
And he's in
Rawhide. You could sing right along with me, Larry.
Yeah, no,
feel free anytime.
But, you know, and he personally rides, his daughter personally rides the reining horses,
yeah.
And that's an excellent, they put on a wonderful reining show here as well.
And the Digert family have a deep connection to the fairgrounds. The fair was actually held at their farm in the 1800s for, I think, one or two summers.
That was
summers.
Grandpa John's, and that's actually only 2 or 3 miles from where I live. And, yes, definitely put on at that farm. That racetrack is still there that they used. And now his uncle owns it, Peter. And it's a nice farm, too.
Yeah, well, that gives you that legacy connection to the Erie County Fair. It's not just because of their expertise. It goes back generationally, and you see that a lot with the people who are here.
Yes.
Deep connections with each other.
We have the results in, and we will start with fifth place going on up to first. Coming in fifth place is Emily Witkowski of Boston, New York, with Yucca Polka Bonanza.
Emily, number five.
Fourth place in your senior English Ec is Megan Stang of Perrysburg, New York with Lady Paradise.
Megan, number four.
Third place in our senior English Ec will go to back number 125, Gabrielle Marchetti of Lockport, New York.
Gabrielle, number three.
Second place in your senior English Ec is going to go to back number 60, Samantha Logan of Eden, New York with Who's Perfect.
Samantha, number two.
And first place in your senior English equitation goes to Miss Brianna Warner of Frewsburg, New York with the Flashy Invitation. Congratulations to all of our riders in the senior English Ec. We will look to get started with junior English equitation.
All right, congratulations.
There'll be nine to work in this class.
Congratulations to Brianna Warner, first class, and first in this class.
Yes, first in this class.
And you're first class too, Larry. And we're going to be back with you right here at the Showplex from Hamburg, New York, right after this.
Milk and cheese and yogurt make me sing every day, because milk is amazing. Drink milk to grow up with strong bones. 3 times a day, vitamin D and calcium. So drink it with chocolate, put it on your pizza. How about berries? It's always a treat. Milk is amazing.
Show me a fillet, show me a strip. A Russell's cut, a ribeye, or a crab dip. Come dine with me just right. Where would you like to have dinner tonight? Russell's, of course. Russell's, of course. But where would you like to have dinner tonight? Russell's, of course.
Be my guest and let us do the rest.
We have Sierra Weissmore, Alexis Wiersba, Charlotte Parsons, Frederick Stevens, Samantha Parsons, Tara Laverne, Elena Barber, Callie Jordan, and Madison Hogue. Please enter the ring at the trot.
All right, so you just heard all the names there from Kirby Digert, and all of those entrants and exhibitors are now coming in, and we're going to see them come by. They're just walking into the Showplex Arena, right near where the WBBZ TV team is positioned. Our Joe Malucci and Andy Smaczynski watching the horses coming right in.
Yep.
They're getting the first look at them before they come through. And our crew here today, including Chris Musial and Rich Lee and Chad and Marcolini. So we've got a full team here from your hometown MeTV station. Happy to participate and be a part of this, gathering up sponsors and delivering this technically to you on WBBZ.TV and Ustream. So here we are, and they're coming in, and this is again for the trot in English equitation in the junior class.
And unlike the senior class, we don't have to split this. It looks like there's 3, 6, 9, 10.
That's exactly right there, Larry. So the junior equitation in this moment in time, we won't have it split in two because we had a number of entrants in the last senior class.
Yes, exactly.
Hundreds of entrants have come forward in the last few months once this was organized, and it kept changing because the rules kept changing and the dynamic kept changing as to whether or not this was going to happen or not. So everybody that's here today is here because they really, really want to be here. And, you know, Larry, usually there would be people in the stands, hundreds
yes.
of people applauding and cheering. How does that impact a horse when they come into a situation with all the people?
It's just like what you're talking about, a comedian being on stage now with no audience. There's nothing
to feed off.
Happens
to me all the time, Larry, yeah.
And, you know, it's nice to have your family here. Horses respond to applause. And we were talking before about certain music. Horses kind of respond to the music. and some horses get nervous in closed areas on these aluminum bleachers and things and somebody popping around on them.
Sure.
I'm liking what I see here. We've got some very nice riders. And some horses performing very nicely.
Now it's a walk.
Yes.
We'll go through the entrance again. Sierra Weissmore, number 36 from Colden, with Dakota Dreamer. Alexis Wiersba from Eden, New York, entrant 41 with Who's Perfect. Charlotte Parsons, entrant number 104 with Copper Tango, who we saw earlier. I believe we saw Who's Perfect earlier, too.
On the rail at the canter, please, all canter.
Frederick Stevens, entrant 123 from North Collins with Santino. Samantha Parsons, entrant 180 with her entrant Bicardi's Dare. Remember that name from South Wales. Tara Lovern, entrant 188 with Electric Checks from Little Valley. Elena Barber, entrant 199, Lookaways on the Mark from Sardinia. Kaylee Jordan, entrant 251 with Hooten Newton. And Madison Hogue, entrant 263 with Hobo's Back. So some of these horses, Larry, and their exhibitors have been in for the showmanship, and now they're coming in for the ride. But not everybody was in other parts of the show.
Correct. You can do showmanship and equitation. You can do a pleasure. And you can make your choices. It's nice at a show like this.
On the rail at the walk, please. Down to
When it's divided up in age group to go in all three sections.
Please reverse at the walk. Reverse at the walk.
Now here comes the reverse, so they're turning around.
Yes.
And I noticed that in the other shows that it's not something where every animal can do, or the exhibitor can do, each phase of the show. They
Exactly.
maybe do all of it, or they do one part of it, based on the animal and based on their level.
Yeah, you might see some horses not doing trail. You might see some horses not doing pleasure, but they're doing equitation because they're judging the rider and not the horse.
Yeah.
Or you might see...
I heard the exhibitor just say walk, and
yes.
the animal's now walking.
Yes.
Should there be verbal cues for the animal, or should it just be a maneuver for the animal?
If there's verbal cues, it should be quiet.
The trot, please.
But it's better to have the verbal cues than to get into kind of trouble.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't want to be shouting it out or yelling out. And because that horse could get other horses in trouble. Or any horse can get other horses in trouble.
And let's talk about this. I mean, little guy.
And it's what you see.
Yeah. And these horses are coming together for the first time. You know, when people come together for the first time, it's always a little awkward. But
yes.
They get used to each other. So they have to, do they have to go through that same
exactly.
process to
exactly.
kind of get acclimated with each other?
Exactly. And if somebody doesn't like somebody and they get too close, they'll tell them. And that could... But most horses that have been in shows have practiced at home with other horses up tight to them. Like in this particular class, there's probably three,
canter,
four horses
on the rail at the canter.
That are coming from different areas and different disciplines. And
so one horse not cantering.
Yes, there we go.
Now it's getting started.
And so now they're changing their whole lifestyle.
I notice the head of the horse tends to go down when the horse is cantering.
Yes. Horses, you hear the phrase, I was going to talk about it in pleasure, but you hear a phrase that the engine is in the rear end. In order to
on
get
the rail
that,
at the walk, please, all walk.
That head goes down because the weight's forward. Reality is you need to squeeze the barrel up with your calves. When the barrel
please
comes
walk
up,
in and line
the
up.
The shoulders come up, they get free,
pen.
And the
once
head
again,
comes up.
Line up, walk
whoops.
In. And
I did notice.
I get animated.
Sorry, right, Larry, we all do. I did notice one horse, an entrant, seemed to be going a little bit faster than the other. It seemed like it was a trot more than a canter.
Yes. And sometimes that happens. They can't get into the canter, so they trot fast.
Yeah.
And if a horse's head is way up, but still perpendicular to the ground, that's not necessarily a bad thing.
Yeah.
But if it's way up and it gets in front of the bit is what we would say, in front of the perpendicular, then you're kind of losing the control of it. But this is a nice little class. There's very nice little riders.
And you want to control the animal.
Exactly. And I would say none of this has been pilot error. All of it is just maybe needed to be a little more training at home.
Yeah.
And with 4-H'ers, that's what it's all about. Yeah, we're learning and training and working.
Every day you learn something. And it doesn't matter your age. You're never stopping that process where you're learning.
Exactly.
And the technology of how you care for your horse and how you feed your horse. What would a horse like this eat?
Well, we kind of discussed this before. You have hay, which is forage, and grain, which is high energy. and water and some sort of pasture or paddock. Horses are grazing animals. A girl was saying the other night, well, I do this for my horse, I do this. And I said, no, you don't. Turn him out in 1,500 acres with no cougars and lots of grass and creeks, and he'll be happy.
Yeah, no cougars. Yeah. Very important.
Yeah. Horses are flight animals, so if they're frightened, they'll do something like try to get away. We were talking about a horse's going a little fast. Well, maybe he's frightened for the other horses in the arena.
Mm-hmm.
But there's used to be an old adage of a horse with no work,
deck will be novice English equitation, novice English eck. You are on deck, and in the hole will be our walk trot English eck.
Horse has to be worked.
Yeah, but if he's not 5 to 10 pounds of hay for every 100 pounds, so a 1,000-pound horse would eat like 50 pounds of hay a day or less.
Wow, that's
and very,
a lot of hay.
Very, very little grain. Then you can kind of decrease the hay and increase the grain as you're working. And there's different charts to do that. And now the feed companies have developed different grains for different levels of performance, so you don't have to worry about so much quantity as the quality that you give them. But no, horses really like forage. We have 3 horses in a pen, and we have a huge, great big bale. And that lasts about 7 days, and they just eat when they want to eat, and they're very happy with it. Other horses wouldn't be so happy, but there's 2 out of those 3. Give me hay, and I'll be happy. You know,
yeah.
You don't have to give me grain. And you know, horses have to be, you should know their TPRs, their temperature, their respiration, and their pulse. Take it in the mornings when they get up. Take it in the evenings when you're there.
How do you take the temperature of a horse?
You're right, rectal.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you're right.
Got to do what you got to do.
Yeah, and the heartbeat.
Congratulations in our junior English equitation. In 5th place will be Frederick Stevens of North Collins, New York, with Santino. 4th place in your junior English act will go to back number 263, Madison Hogue of Salamanca, New York, with Hobo's Back. 3rd place will go to back number 188, Tara Laverne of Little Valley, New York, with Electric Checks. 2nd place in this class is going to go to back number 199, Elena Barber of Sardinia, New York, with Lookaways on the Mark. And 1st place in your junior English act is back number 41, Who's Perfect, and Alexis Wiersba of Eden, New York. Congratulations to all of our riders in your junior English eck class. We will look to get started with novice English equitation.
All right, so we
that was a nice
Alexis.
Class.
Yeah,
yes,
it was a nice
Alexis
class.
And the 2nd place, they were both equal. They both rode different types of horses, and that easily could have made that little bit of difference.
Yeah, you know, Alexis Wiersba walks away with number 1 in that class, your junior English equitation. We're going to be back with Larry Thurber here from the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, at the Western New York Youth and Ag Bonanza after this break from the great sponsors that are bringing this to you streaming live. We'll be right back.
Make me healthy, stronger, please.
Milk Times 3 is good for me. Milk Times 3 is good for me. Milk Times 3 is good for me.
Want the best for your pets? Decide on Clyde's. Most people think their best deal is with online retailers, but I'm always getting the best price at Clyde's Feed and Animal Center. Shop Clydesfeed.com for convenient 1 to 3 day shipping to your doorstep. They've got a great selection of food for every pet, from dogs and cats to horses and chickens, wild birds, and everything in between. You'll find more than food. Shop toys, treats, flea and tick treatment, grooming supplies, vitamins, supplements, and more at Clyde's Feed and Clydesfeed.com.
Hello, I'm Ross Salvatore, wishing all the youth competing in the Ag Bonanza good luck. I'm sorry I can't be with you in Hamburg. Remember, hard work and good showmanship pays off. I hope to see you and your families soon at Russell's Steaks, Chops, and More.
Hope for Health, sponsoring and presenting to you, bringing it home, the Western New York Youth and Ag Bonanza and the English Showmanship Performance and Trail and the Novice English Equation. That's what we're looking at right now. And the entrants coming into the Showplex ring that are watching and riding are Alexis Gavin, number 3 of East Aurora, with her animal Marvin. Erica Skuse, number 121 from Boston, New York, her horse Luke at Mayella. Kylie Rower, with her animal Sadie from Salamanca, New York. And Taylan Nugent, entrant 186, with her animal MMA Proud. We've seen most of these animals before. And we were talking, Larry, during the break. Well, in the previous segment, we talked about how important eating is, and Clyde's Animal and Feed Center in Lockport and Hamburger, our sponsor, helping to bring this home to you. And if you need to get something for your horse or any animal, you need to go there. And if there is something specific, you'll find it there. Here comes Kirby.
On the rail at the walk, please, I'll walk.
I'm telling him to walk. But we also mentioned, in addition to eating, the grooming of the animal. And in my notes, it, in other ways that shows are staged, they would be judged on grooming.
Yes.
But in this case, it's just anecdotal that a horse needs to be groomed constantly.
Yes. And like we were talking about fitting in showmanship, When you groom them correctly, the natural oils come
Attention,
out in the natural hairs.
We are going to take our lunch break at noon. We will work through our senior English pleasure. Senior English pleasure, we are going to work through that class before lunch break. So senior English pleasure, please make your way to the warm-up pen. Currently in the ring is our novice English Eck, followed by Walk Trot. Please be on the rail at the canter. All canter, please.
So now they're cantering. This is the 7th particular show that we've watched today in our segments.
Yes.
And in this novice English equation, you're again looking at younger people with less time to work with the animal.
Yes, they've ridden less than 2 years.
You may not see that level of perfection or spot-on movement that you saw in some of the other exhibitors that were here.
And, you know, we're going back to the grooming.
Yep.
There's a curry comb that you would use, and then a stiffer brush and a hard brush, and sometimes just your hands in a towel. And that allows the dirt and dander to come up, and then you get rid of it.
The mane and tail comb.
Yep. Then you do the mane and tail combs.
The hoof pick and hook.
Yes. Most important of those are the hoof picks, because you should pick those horses' hooves every day.
Because they're stepping on all kinds of mud and debris and things, so yeah, you got to keep it clean. And for the safety of the animal, you don't want them to get infected with
on
the
rail
cut.
At the walk,
exactly,
please,
exactly.
Walk.
And because Clyde's is here in Hamburg, you can get all that equipment right at Clyde's. And
please reverse at the walk. Reverse at the walk.
And our 4-H office used to have different programs and books you can
Once
get
again,
to see how to
do
things.
Once again, attention to all riders. We are going to work through our senior English pleasure before our lunch break. We will work through the senior English pleasure before lunch break. Please on the rail at the trot, all trot.
Now they're all trotting. We should mention, Larry, you were a teacher at BOCES for many, many years in special education.
Yes.
So that's a gift from God, believe me, for everything that you've done for those young people along the way.
Well, God allowed me to do everything from bus driving to regular, to work my way up to aide, to assistant, to teaching, and it's just been a great career, and the judging has been phenomenal.
Yeah, because you really are living multiple lives here.
Yes.
You think about it, you're a teacher, and that's one skill set, and then your expertise. Do you read up on the animals a lot? Is it something you've just learned from your experience? Do you
learn from many, many? Every 3 years, I have to be recertified and retested.
Yeah.
And you're always reading something new as it comes along.
On the rail, the walk, please. I'll walk.
How do you think they're doing on the walk as novices?
As novices at the walk, they're doing quite well. And overall, they're doing well. Each one has their little blips, and they got to work through it.
On the rail at the canter, please. All canter.
Now we're moving to the canter. It's very difficult.
Actually, this was, everyone got their leads. Well, maybe not. The one thing I got to tell you, this is so important. Everybody says, well, my horse this or that. There's a horse over there that came up to another horse, and he's taking care of his rider. The rider is saying canter, but I'm not really ready to canter, and that horse is taking care of her. He started to canter, she started to flip, and he just broke right back down.
And he just responded to the fact that it was not going to be safe for the rider.
Yes.
How does, I guess it's just psychic, how does that
horse
connect?
On the rail, the walk, please, down to the walk, and make your way into the lineup facing the warm-up pen. Please walk into lineup facing the warm-up pen.
As you were kind of know
that. How does that going to be your walk trot? English equitation.
As you mentioned.
In the hole will be senior English pleasure. Senior English pleasure. Yeah, we are going to show that class before our 20-minute lunch break.
Well, as you mentioned before, in the showmanship.
Once again, in the center of the ring facing the warm-up pen.
It's you and your horse work together, and a little thing about your right leg moving forward so your horse sees its shoulder, and you work together and you walk and that. And this is the same way with horses. Not all horses are like that. Some horses say, yeah, on my back, hang on, I'm going. And, I mean, that's I can't say the word. Anthropomorphized. You put human emotions to a horse. But horses are different. And if you're soft and gentle with them, they'll take care of you.
Yeah.
Like that little girl was doing everything she could, but not quietly, and he cantered, and then we got with that other horse where she could get in trouble. He just said, whoop, I'm walking now.
Yeah.
And that's not, I mean, how much is that worth to have your daughter on a horse like that, you know?
Yeah, you want the safety of the rider,
yeah.
Because you don't want to fall. I've heard of people fall, well, obviously, there's been some horrible stories of people who fall on horses, and Christopher Reeve being the most years and years ago, but you know, that probably on one end of the spectrum, but still, there's safety issue to be had there, so you're right. And if the horse needs to change the dynamic, the safety of the rider, that's great that there's that instinctual thing that's happening.
There's a little pony years ago.
Why does the horse move that? I'm sorry, you tell the story about the pony. Tell the story about
the pony. Well, the pony, this girl, there's no question, there's 15, 20 horses in. No question the girl's going to win the class. And she's trotting along, and this little girl on this little pony, and the girl was crying so hard, and the little pony was just walking around with her, not being naughty, just taking care of her. And the pony and the little girl that I had came up behind them and stopped and walked right with her for the rest of the class, would not leave that little girl's side. And I was like, okay, and that taught me a lot that day.
That's the beautiful story.
Yeah, just pay attention.
Yep, and you hear those stories a lot. Why does the horse move their leg?
Well, congratulations in our novice English equitation. Fifth place in this class is going to go to back number 3, Alexis Gavin of East Aurora, New York, with Marvin. Fourth place in this class is going to go to back number 190, Taylor Griffin. Third place will go to Talon Nugent, back number 180 of Allegheny, New York. Second place is going to go to back number 3rd place is going to go to back number 186, Talon Nugent of Allegheny, New York. 2nd place will go to Erica Skuse, back number 121 of Boston, New York. And 1st place, back number 152, Kylie Rower of Salamanca, New York.
Good. The answer to your question, the horse's legs going up and down, but you also see the tail going back and forth? Little flies are biting them.
Oh, little flies, that's right. Well, we have some sponsors that will bite me if we don't get a chance to get them acknowledged right here on our stream at WBBZ.TV and Ustream. We'll be back with my good friend, and we'll be seeing you for more of the great Western New York Youth and Ag Bonanza.
Imagine a world without milk. It would be a tragic, tasteless existence. After all, with no cheese, how would anyone know when to smile? With no milk, Why would anyone want to? But there is hope. Your Western New York dairy farmers are committed to providing the most wholesome, delicious milk products possible, returning smiles to tables and order in the universe.
So, everyone's okay with a cow in the house?
Milk for Health. The guys with the cows.
Saturday night is movie night on WBBZ-TV. The fun starts at 6 p.m. with The Three Stooges. Then at 8, Svengoolie screens the classics.
Kerwin.
And later at midnight, Buffalo Beatniks, Zelda, Bird, and Theo serve up hot coffee and cool movies on Offbeat Cinema.
Keep watching the skies. Keep watching.
And keep watching WBBZ-TV, your hometown MeTV station. Channel 67.1 on air and DirecTV, Channel 5 on cable, Fios, and Dish.
Welcome back to the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, the Erie County Fairgrounds. I'm here with Larry Thurber, John DeShula with you on the Ustream feed at WBBZ.TV and also on the Western New York Youth and Ag Bonanza page. We're coming to you in a non-spectator event because of the COVID restrictions, but one of the only events happening here at the fairgrounds this summer. This would have been the final weekend coming up at the fair. Right now, Larry, we're in the Walk Trot English Equitation, and I'll go through the entrants who are here. Paige Sims, number 74, from Eden, New York, with her horse Given an Invitation to Dream. Ethan Hoffman, number 122, with her animal Good Girls Go Far. I'm sorry, his animal, Ethan, from Hinsdale, New York. Crystal White with Electric Checks, nice. Little Valley, New York. Crystal, the youngest entrant, I believe, here today. Anastasia Beaver, number 205, with Zippin' and Jazzin' from Hamburg, New York. And Grace Connolly, number 237, T-Sugar-Coated. This is the Walk Trot English Equitation. So these entrants are now looking at doing what we've seen in the walk. And will they canter and will they trot?
No, it's just what it is. It's walk, trot.
Just walk and trot.
Right. At home they may have cantered, but not. They're not ready to show it, the canter tonight.
Okay.
And something we didn't quite get a finish of, we were talking about TPRs, temperature, respiration, and pulse.
Yeah.
And you do it in the morning and in the afternoon because there's actually a difference in the morning and the afternoon. And the reason you need to know these things, if you think there's something wrong when you call your veterinarian, you can tell him what these numbers are and if they're different than what they normally are. And
so
that will help your veterinarian. What would
in class, we have our walk trot English equitation in the Showplex here today. Entries from Paige Sims, Ethan Hoffman, Crystal White, Anastasia Beaver, and Grace Connolly.
Now, this class happens to have one of your little favorites in. Do you
we are on the rail
see
at the
it
walk.
Yet? Did you
on
see
the rail
oh,
at
there
the walk.
She is.
Yep. That's Crystal.
Yeah.
And she's walking. There it is. 151 with Electric Checks.
Yes. And as a judge, you need to look at the positives of everything. And you can't take favorites, but...
Yeah.
You did, and that's okay.
I guess because of the fact that I'm enamored with the youth and how they've been able to learn at such a young age and continue with it.
Yes.
And they work with these animals for years and get to this level and caring, and they care for the animal. You know, saying, Larry, this is not all about show. This is cleaning out the stalls. It's messy work.
Yes.
Let's call it for what it is. And that's not always pleasant, but some life disciplines there. You got to groom that horse, like we said,
yep,
every day, brush it.
Yep, you get
on
up every morning.
On the rail at the trot, please, all trot.
Twice another a day minimum on feeding, maybe three times. And with a boarding barn situation, and
yes,
somebody always takes care of stuff. But every time the students come around where I have my horse, I'll say, "Look in his stall. What does it look like? Any marks on the wall? Is the stall stirred around?"
Yep. We should mention the boarding barns are where you're basically paying a fee to.
Exactly.
Participate in the care and feeding and ownership on some level, I guess, of the horse.
Right.
But certainly there is another level where somebody will care for that animal if the individual who's boarding is not available.
Right. Well, and but it's called Full Care, and they'll take care of your horse, feed and water and pasture and in out, turn in and out. And then there's partial care, which you maybe clean your horse,
reverse
or you maybe clean and feed it, and that they just own
the
stall and the pasture. So there's different possibilities.
Yes.
And because there was a number of years where I was on the road a lot, so I had to do full care.
Yep, you had to do the full care.
Yeah, yes. And where I'm particularly at, there's a number of...
Looks
like we're cantering, but we're going to slow down.
We're going to slow it down. We're moving across the ring there.
Yeah. Remember we talked about the different songs for different levels?
Yes.
On the rail at the trot, please, all trots.
And for the first two winners there, everybody was talking about me knowing all the 4-H kids. And I said, I keep my horse where the pigs and the heifers and the chickens are. I don't know these kids. So they had me judge a major event for them the next year. Truly, I did not know those kids from our barn. I did not know them.
Really?
Three of them I knew. And it made me feel good to think that I could evaluate them honestly.
Well, you're a pretty honest guy here, Larry, I will say. You know, you're calling things as you see them and...
Be polite, pleasant about it.
And yeah. What kind of, you know, horse is a horse, of course, but what kind of animals... What kind of animals do they get along with best?
Horses are definitely a herd animal. They like themselves. When I was a teenager in college, I had a horse and I had a duck. I hatched it out. That horse and that duck were such good friends. The duck would hear us coming back. I don't know how. The duck would wait for us to come back. Other ones have little goats they like. Racehorses and goats are
mm-hmm.
big.
Goats are rather unique.
Yep. And I don't care what pet my horse has, as long as...
On the rail at the trot, please, all trot.
As long as when we're working, they understand that we need to work together and not... It's not your time to play with your pet.
Yeah. That's an interesting line you just said. As much as there's a connection to the horse, it's not a pet. It's
correct.
An animal that has a function. And this is not something that just kind of kicks around the house like a... Little Chihuahua dog.
Exactly. And I love Chihuahuas and nothing against them.
No, I love them too.
But they also...
But it's a pet.
They also bark and think they're great big dogs. yes, and as I look around this walk trot, I see a couple horses I would definitely put my child on and a couple more that just need to be a little more wet saddle yeah. blankets.
How does it... The taming of the horse...
Down to the walk, please. I'll walk.
If you're working...
Please walk your way into lineup facing the warm-up pen. Once again, walk into lineup facing the warm-up arena. On deck will be your senior English pleasure. This will be the last class before our lunch break. There are two splits in our senior English pleasure.
So the taming of the horse.
And you used to hear this, I broke my horse or my horse is broke.
Yeah.
Well, years ago, that's what they did on the Ramunda out west. They grabbed a horse and rode it till it stopped bucking.
And then
now we have other ways to train our horses and soft, quiet training. I use a real soft tone of voice. If they don't understand that, a medium tone. And if they're really naughty, they'll get the deep tone.
Yeah.
And this young lady I knew had heard me say whoa to my horse, and he slammed on the binders and he slid down the barn aisle.
Mm-hmm.
And when my horse got in trouble outside, here's this little girl trying to lower her voice, going whoa, image whoa. So you never know who's looking, but I will tell you that girl has shown today and done very well. And but I'm not a trainer. I don't train her. Things she picks up seeing me do with my horse. And
so you think some of these novices that are here exhibiting work with trainers as well?
Trainers or their 4-H leaders or something.
Yeah.
And
they're going to need some guidance on how to
yes.
do riding and caring.
Yes. And I'm thinking by the addresses that I'm hearing you say, There's a couple facilities down south of Western New York here, Southern Tier. And so I'm thinking there's a couple barns down there that, you know, when you're around everybody, you pick up stuff. And you have a trainer or teacher or your 4-H leaders. And there's a lot of 4-H leaders that want to be a leader. And they're good at the civic stuff and good at the promotions and having the groups help in nursing homes and different things. But they don't know enough about horses, so they got to get somebody else in to teach them.
Yeah, you want to make sure you get the right training. And 4-H, you talk about a lot about 4-H. You have a real deep connection, Larry, to the 4-H.
Absolutely. Well, all youth. We were talking about that before, and it's all youth. But 4-H got me started in my life in a bad time in my life, and it set me on this career path. Who knows that I was going to do all this, you know, and be all these places.
Well, you've traveled the world. If you're just joining us on Ustream, Larry Thurber is our guest. He's been with us all morning. We started at 9 a.m. here at the Showplex in Hamburg at the Erie County Fairgrounds. Duke Dygert is our judge, and we're taking a look before our lunch break, and this is the Walk Trot English Equation, and here comes Kirby.
Well, congratulations in our Walk Trot English Equitation. Coming in fifth place will be Grace Connolly of West Seneca, New York, with T Sugarcoated. Fourth, back number 237 will be coming in fifth place. Fourth place will be back number 122, Ethan Hoffman of Hinsdale, New York, with Good Girls Go Far. Third place in this class will go to back number 205, Anastasia Beaver of Hamburg, New York, with Zippin' in Jazzin'. Second place is going to go to back number 151, Crystal White of Little Valley, New York, with Electric Chess. And coming in first place is back number 74, Paige Sims of Eden, New York, with Ben Invitation to Dream. Once again, congratulations to all the riders in that class. We are going to work our senior English pleasure before our lunch break. There will be two splits here in this class.
So the senior English pleasure is coming up next, but congratulations
Riders,
to Paige Sims.
Riders, we will
Sims.
Ask you to enter at the trot.
And congratulations to Crystal White, our young entrant, number two.
Very,
Not
very
so
good.
Bad. Yeah.
Really pleased with both of them, and they deserved what they got.
Yeah.
They good
coming
round.
In split
they did
one
have a good
will
ride,
be
and we're
going
to be back
Alyssa
now and
Graziano,
take a look at the seniors.
Elena
when we come
Endress,
back right after this
Liana,
from Western New York Youth and Ag Bonanza.
Emma
we'll be right back.
Samantha Logan.
Cheese and yogurt make me sing every day, 'cause milk is amazing. Drink milk to grow up with strong bones, 3 times a day, vitamin D and calcium. So drink it with chocolate, put it on your pizza. How about berries? It's always a treat. Milk is amazing.
Show me a fillet, show me a strip. A Russell's cut, a ribeye, or a crab dip. Come dine with me just right. Where would you like to have dinner tonight? Russell's, of course. Russell's, of course. Where would you like to have dinner tonight? Russell's, of course.
Be my guest and let us do the rest.
We are back at the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, the Erie County Fairgrounds. John DeShula with you with Larry Thurber and our judge, Duke Dygert. And right now we've crossed into a different category, Senior English Pleasure. And Larry explained.
Yes. Up to this point, we've been looking at the person in showmanship, how they handle the horse on the ground. And we've been looking at the person, how they're riding. Now we're looking at the horse as... How is he? And as a judge, you only get a few seconds to look at each horse. You want your horse to come in, is his head set, like almost perpendicular? Then you look from behind and see if he's moving off his hind end and got his hocks underneath him.
So the horses are judged on their manners, performance,
yes,
quality, conformation, and the horse is basically, we're looking at it whether it's a pleasure to ride or not.
Down to
yes,
the walk, please.
And
all walk.
As you said, the consistency of the ride from that point on. So when they come in, you look at those things, and then is the horse consistent? The other thing we haven't mentioned all day is you look at a horse and you think quality of movement. The better the quality, the better the placings. And sometimes you have to say, we're not veterinarians, but we have to say, is it quality of maneuver or is it sore or lame?
On the rail, the canter, please, all canter.
So this is a judge that's looking at the horse itself, not the exhibitor, as we had in
exactly,
another.
Exactly. And the fact that we have Arabs, Morgans, some mixed breeds, and some quarter horses, each one moves differently. So you have to evaluate how each horse would move in its own breed to put it together. You know, is the thoroughbred moving as good as a thoroughbred can move?
Let's talk about the term thoroughbred, because we hear
yes,
a lot of that when we get into the Kentucky Derby and the Belmont Stakes. What is a thoroughbred horse?
Thoroughbred is a bloodline of horses. There's a thoroughbred. There's a standardbred that drives, that races a lot. Thoroughbreds race on with a saddle.
Down to the walk, please. All walk.
Then we have quarter horses and Arabs, so it's all a blood breed. You bleed thoroughbred to thoroughbred, and you get a thoroughbred. Years ago, the word thoroughbred used to be synonymous
please
with
reverse and continue to walk. Reverse and continue to walk.
Purebred horse, but that was incorrect. It's a breed of its all of its own.
The horses that are here, we're going to talk about the split. The exhibitors, Alyssa Graziano, number 5 from Forestville with Vibella in Chautauqua County. Elena Endres, number 10 with Sabotage from Hamburg. Liana Elliott from Buffalo, with She's Ritzy, entrance 17. Emma Saplicki, number 31, with So Magical from Holland, New York. Samantha Logan, number 60, with her horse Who's Perfect. Eliza Schrantz, number 65, with Zipson's Betty Bright
on
from
rail,
Jerry.
The trot, please, all trot.
They're trotting now. Emily Wachowski with Yucca Poco Bonanza from Boston, New York. Brianna Myers back, number 94, with Paintress Kelly. And as we continue, Aaron Hayes, number 119, Song and a Prayer from Holland, New York. And Gabrielle Marchetti, number 125, from Lockport, with Potential Chocolate. So we have Erie Niagara Chautauqua represented here in the Showplex here in Hamburg. And interesting to learn about the thoroughbred, standardbred, quarter horse, and the Arab. So what is next for these horses? Like, do they go on to some of them become racehorses, some of them workhorses?
With the thoroughbreds.
Please canter on
generally,
the rail
this is
canter.
Their life after the track. Some of these horses could go into western riding or reining. Some could go into trail. Some could go into trail riding. Others may stay show horses for the next 5-6 years.
So they're show horses and they're in their barns,
yep,
and they are cared for and they go out and children ride them,
yes,
exhibitors ride them.
Yep.
So there's interesting ways that the horse can live its life, but always with a meaning
on
and
the rail,
a purpose.
The trot,
yes,
please, all
and
trot.
These particular horses can always go on from the 4-H route to their breed
shows. Please
trot
in and line up facing
there's
the warm-up
pen. Quarter horse breed show, there's a paint breed show, there's Arab show, Pinot shows. So every one of these horses could go on to a specific avenue. The ones that don't have breeds per se, they might go on and do some over fence work. They might go on and do some police work. So your horses,
yeah,
could do whatever they needed to do.
Yeah, we see the Erie County Sheriffs and
yes,
they have a whole division, a mounted
yes,
division.
And those horses are very well trained. Off your legs and don't worry about it. Go through.
I've seen them. My friend Wayne Wolf is a Erie
yes,
County Sheriff. Large horse.
Yes.
He's
had
a couple
nice horses over the years.
Yeah, makes a commanding presence.
Yes, it does.
And they go to the big events
this
downtown.
This is the first split
yep,
of our senior English pleasure. We do have a second split. We'll bring all of those back in to compete for your final class, the Senior English Pleasure. Following that, we will take a 20-minute lunch break and start back with Junior English Pleasure.
So here we are.
For those of you ringside riders and those at home watching on our live feed, joining us today is Miss Libby Kelkenberg of Libby Lee Imagery and Design. If you are interested in any of the photos that Libby has taken throughout the weekend, we will post her Smug Mug link on our Facebook page as well as on our website.
So the photographer taking individual photos, which will be keepsakes for these families, and of course the video that people are watching, keepsakes for their loved ones as well, the parents, grandparents, family members, and others watching in West New York and across the country.
And this live feed is so good for so many people, especially now we were talking about the COVID before. What an opportunity to see an event, and maybe even somebody you know in it. And it's a great thing that you're doing.
And the beautiful, elegant animal that is the horse.
Yes.
And here they all lined up, looking very...
And the horses are a whole different ball game.
Yeah.
They attune to you even more than cattle do, but horses are even more. And you can make that bond with them.
Coming back to compete in our final class of Senior English Pleasure, back number 10, Elena Endress of Hamburg, New York. Back number 60, Samantha Logan of Eden, New York. Back number 67, Emily Witkowski of Boston, New York. Back number 119, Aaron Hayes of Holland, New York. And back number 125, Gabrielle Marchetti of Lockport, New York. At this time, we will excuse you from the ring and bring in split two of our Senior English Pleasure. We'll be looking for Jessica Nickerson, Megan Stang, Taylor Finnerty, Taylor Grover, Brianna Warner, Jillian Buckert, Maggie Knoll, Samantha Syracuse, Sarah Cox, and Taylor Bentley.
All right, so
after this second split, we'll bring all of those
Kirby
back to
just announced
for
the
your
names
top
that are coming in for the
English
second
after
part of
English
our split
pleasure,
here. And we're going to take a quick break here, Larry, as we get ready for the next group of horses and exhibitors from the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, as the West New York Youth and Ag Bonanza continues. We'll be right back.
Want the best for your pets? Decide on Clyde's. Most people think their best deal is with online retailers, but I'm always getting the best price at Clyde's Feed and Animal Center. Shop Clydesfeed.com for convenient 1 to 3 day shipping to your doorstep. They've got a great selection of food for every pet, from dogs and cats to horses and chickens, wild birds, and everything in between. You'll find more than food. Shop toys, treats, flea and tick treatment, grooming supplies, vitamins, supplements, and more at Clyde's Feed and Clydesfeed.com.
Connect with WBBZ-TV, your hometown MeTV station. Channel 67.1 over the air and DirecTV, Channel 5 on cable, Fios, and Dish.
Chill out with some hot classics.
Online at our website, WBBZ.TV, with information about your favorite shows and hometown buzz.
Feeling a little frisky?
Join the conversation at WBBZ-TV on Facebook, at WBBZ on Twitter, and check out our YouTube channel with playlists of our hometown programming.
Yes, sir, I'm going to lay around home and just take it easy.
WBBZ on TV and online, your hometown MeTV station.
John DeShula with you with Larry Thurber, and we are here at the Showplex watching the horse show, and this is now the second split in the Senior English Pleasure division, and individuals who are on the exhibit floor on the Showplex, Jessica Nickerson, number 135, with her horse Flame from Orchard Park, Megan Stang, 167, Lady Paradise, from Perrysburg, Taylor Finnerty from Clarence with her horse I'm All Good, number 189. Taylor Grover, number 191, from Cheektowaga with SHF Made from Scratch. Brianna Warner, again back, 214 from Frewsburg with DeFlashy Invitation. Jillian Buchard, number 250, from Lancaster with ABD Jake of Diamonds. Maggie Knoll from East Aurora, number 264 with Dakota Fire Eclipse. Samantha Syracuse, 280, with Good Luck Charlie from Alden, New York. Sarah Cox, number 282, from Warsaw, with her horse Awesome Artist, and Taylor Bentley, 283 from Buffalo, with her horse Harley. So a lot of great representation from all over Western New York, Larry, that we see here today in these young exhibitors.
Yes, and something that I noticed while we're talking, it's the vernacular of what breed you're in or where you're at. Right today we're calling it splits when they split the class. Other areas you might hear called cuts. Mm-hmm. This arena, we call it arena. I'm down in Missouri, they'll call it a pen, P-E-N. Mm-hmm. So there's a definite vernacular in the horse world. And the first time I realized that was when somebody said they were in high water.
Walk, please. I'll walk.
And I went, oh, the quality of the horses are good. That's what they meant. The quality of horses were excellent.
Because sometimes you hear the word, I'm in high water, could mean you're up to your knees in something that isn't good.
You shouldn't be.
So the horse, please, all canter.
So the horses now are on the exhibit floor. This is split number two. The individuals who are selected in this split will then come back in just a second with the individuals from split one.
Yes.
And then we'll get our division winners in senior English pleasure.
Yes.
And then our lunch break will follow after that. So here they are in their English garb, and the judge is looking at the horse.
Yes.
And we've talked about the grooming of the horse and the cleanliness, and it's interesting, the more I've looked up horses, like, you know, we talked about the mane and the tail.
Yes.
But there are so many different ways that, you know, like we talked about dressage, Western, Hunter, Arabian, saddlebred, all of the mane styles.
Yes.
So just as you have a hairstyle, the mane style.
Yes.
And I guess that's just a choice that the exhibitor has with their horse, or based on the length, based on the length of the mane.
Like this 280 horse, his stock horses have
down
a
trot,
short
please.
Mane.
All trot.
And they can have it banded, they can have it braided, or they can leave it free. This horse happens to be banded, which is little bands in
reverse
the...
Reverse that the trot, please. Reverse
or this morning we saw... I saw three different ways of braiding the horse's mane. Individual braids, or a French braid, or the other one, I keep forgetting what it's called, braids all the way down the neck.
Yeah, braiding and banding. And will the horse be judged on their manes and how they're groomed?
Overall appearance.
So then, that would include anything from the cleanliness to the hoof and the shine of the hoof.
And whatever draws your eye to that horse, you might not figure out it's the way it's braided, but there's something about that horse that's going to draw your eye, a real positive.
Yeah.
There's a horse in here I keep looking at and looking at and looking at, and I'm like,
which one?
Well, I can't tell you that.
Oh, okay.
Down to the walk, please. I'll walk.
Till we find out where it places.
Yeah.
But it's just something that draws my eye. And I will say this, the judge tries to see
on the
all
rail
that he can see.
Canter, please. All canter.
And sometimes you just can't. You just, something happens, and it's fixed and corrected, and you never saw it.
And the shine and sheen of the coat.
Yes.
Is interesting. And I even noticed in doing my research, you know, it says here you got to make sure if you're clipping the ears and making sure the horse is groomed, you want to keep a little hair in the ears because that's their protection against flies and insects.
Exactly. And in 4-H, if a judge were to ask you about the ears, you can say he's outside, so he's involved with bugs. Unless I have a horse on a horse show circuit, major circuit, I don't clip his inside of his ears. I just don't. But if I'm a major circuit, then I have to do that.
Trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen. Trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen.
And there again, it's 4-H is a learning experience.
And even the tack that the rider is sitting on has to have an even set on the back of the horse.
Yes.
Because you don't want to harm the horse.
Yes.
You know, you don't want to be too heavy, too light. You want to make sure that it's even. And how do you make that determination on the tack?
Western saddles you see a lot more because you can adjust the padding. But the horse just went by us now and he's got padding behind. So he's not sore on that back and loin area. There's another one that's padding up front so he's not hurting his wither area. And you really do need to look at those things. But something we didn't mention, we talked about the grooming, and you all of a sudden notice when you go by and the lights hit it, that's from the grooming, that oil and the hair. But then there's the bridle and saddle and the breast collar. You have to have those clean. And that bit, there better not be any green stuff on that bit. And when I work with 4-H families, it's always like, oh, when you're stressed, you may yell at your mom or your dad or something. But remember one nice thing about your mom and dad that day. And I said, I bet your dad will be up with a towel and brush her boots off at the in gate. And it works. It works.
Yep, there you go. And the boots have to be clean.
Yep.
Every girl
has her hair done very nicely now.
Yes.
Not a lot of things flying out of their helmets. And I don't know how they do it, but a lot of girls now have very long hair. But when they come into these classes, it looks very nice and neat.
Now there's one horse kind of moving around a little bit.
Yes. He's just not comfortable standing still between the noise and the other horses. And we have another horse that says, thank you for stopping. Now I can take care of things.
Yep.
And we were talking about the foot moving and the tail moving.
Congratulations, in our second split of senior English pleasure coming back to compete will be back number 167, Megan Stain out of Perrysburg, New York. 214, Brianna Warner of Frewsburg, New York. Back number 250, Jillian Buckert of Lancaster, New York. Back number 264, Maggie Knoll of East Aurora, New York. And back number 282, Sarah Cox of Warsaw, New York.
Oh, good.
Congratulations to all the riders in our second split of senior English pleasure. After we excuse these riders from the ring, we will look to start our final section of senior English pleasure.
Did you agree with the judge there, Larry, on some of the horses?
Oh, certainly. Yeah. They're very nice. The story that I was thinking is when you're this age, it's nice to get through the class.
Yeah.
Then the next session is, oh, it'd be nice to
riders
that
cut. Made it into our final heat of senior English pleasure. Yeah. Let's get our.
Well, now these horses are going to come back, and while they get back into the ring, we're going to take a break and be back here with Larry Thurber from the Showplex in Hamburg, New York. We'll be right back.
Sing every day, 'cause milk is amazing. Drink milk to grow up with strong bones. 3 times a day, vitamin D and calcium. So drink it with chocolate, put it on your pizza. How about berries? It's always a treat. Milk is amazing.
Hello, I'm Ross Salvatore, wishing all the youth competing in the Egg Bonanza good luck. I'm sorry I can't be with you in Hamburg. Remember, hard work and good showmanship pays off. I hope to see you and your families soon at Russell's Steaks, Chops, and More.
We are back here at the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, the Erie County Fairgrounds. John DeShulo with you with Larry Thurber, and just saw Russ Salvatore there, and he's supporting the young people. All of these sponsors here, Larry, are pitching in to help bring the young people here to the Showplex. I mean, certainly they're getting their message out about their respective businesses, but they're doing this really because they wanted to make sure that this event could happen.
Yes.
That we could pull it off, that we could bring it to you as a live stream, and that the Erie County Fair and Agricultural Society could pull it off as a team. And you see the banners around the room for some of the others, including Lindy, the former Praxair, Evans Bank, celebrating 100 years. These logos appear on the bottom of the screen that Andy and Joe are putting up for you to see as well. And we're doing that because we couldn't do it without them. We really couldn't do any of this. Tractor Supply, Milk for Health, as we mentioned. And even the company that supplies all of the bedding you know, for the animals.
Yes.
Really important when the pigs and the goats were hanging around.
Yes.
Tops Friendly Markets, Milk for Health, of course, and they were obviously an overarch sponsor for the fair as
On
well.
On the rail, the walk, please. I'll walk.
So now they're walking, and so we're seeing the best of
yes
the seniors in Division One in English, and Division One and Two, or Split One and Two. Yeah. And here they are back.
And also, we're talking about sponsorships. It's not all businesses that's sponsored. There's an organization called Western Chapter of the New York State Horse Council. And I called the council and said, you know, this is happening. Do you know about this? So we sponsored.
Canter, please, on the rail at the canter, please.
Sorry. But I just was wanting to say, you know, it's not all, and it's some private individuals as well. And like you said, Salvatore's, and it's just a need to get out here and get this done.
Yeah.
And
we had a little fun with this promo. We when some of the cows were seeing him, we thought they'd run away, but they didn't. But these horses look beautiful. And
Steakhouse.
That's right. They're moving along, and every once in a while you see one that just kind of breaks free a little bit, has its own thought.
Own agenda.
Yep.
But you know, this is a very nice class, and as you look around, and whatever, there's going to be something that just strikes your eye, and then you're going to look at it. And
down to the trot, please. All trot.
So they're watching the horse. The Duke,
yes.
Digert, the judge, is looking at the horse. Of course, the exhibitor has to show confidence in controlling the horse, but the actual
yes.
animal, the appearance. You know, Larry, in some of the other shows, particularly in one of the cattle shows, one of the animals really could have injured one of the exhibitors.
Yes.
I haven't seen that at any moment here with any of these horses.
Down to the walk, please.
They're
all
jumped
walk.
Up
quite
on
well.
Their hind legs or anything.
They're,
yeah, they've all been
well
very,
trained.
Very well trained and very even
please
tempered.
Please reverse
today.
At
yes.
the walk. Reverse at the walk.
I mean, everybody has to start somewhere, but today's show has been pretty good.
How do you handle a horse that might be a little untoward? Decide.
I'm a little more experienced now than a younger person might be. And mine is to say they're rearing up and striking.
Yeah.
I'll stand there on the lead rope and, are you finished yet? Get down here. Whereas somebody else is, you know, pounding on the lead rope and things like that. There's every way.
On the rail at the canter, please. All canter.
There's many ways to accomplish something now with a horse. But it's much easier to be calm and collected and get things done in a nice, quiet manner.
You know, we do a lot of television programs at WBBZ-TV with dentists, with Todd Shatkin, and you're reading the notes, it mentions that the care of the horse also includes the teeth.
Yes.
And it was interesting to see how important that is.
Yes. And both veterinarians and there's some private individuals that do the teeth. And my horse is done every year, just like clockwork. And
so if you're going to involve yourself with a horse, you have to make sure that you're ready to do it.
Yes.
You have the means to make sure that you can do this right, because I have seen, you know, Chris Musial and I used to work in news.
Down
yes.
to the trot, please. All trot.
And we used to cover stories of animals that were living in filthy conditions.
Yes.
And it just broke your heart. And so you have to make sure you're really covered, because you have to treat the animal humanely. If you're not able to do it, don't do it.
Yes. Yes, and you might not know until you get into it how much, but you have. If you board it, what does that include? Does not include vet bills, does not include shoeing or trimming, does not include teeth.
Please trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen. Trot in and line up facing the warm-up pen.
Makes
a
sense.
A reminder that after this class, we will take a lunch break and get started back with Junior English Pleasure.
You know,
Junior English Pleasure, we will start back up after lunch break.
The teeth are going to chew that hay, and you don't
yes.
want to waste anything. And
yes.
The nourishment is, it's not unlike a human.
Well, and horses don't chew up and down, they chew sideways, which means part of their teeth get little hooks on them.
Oh.
And those little hooks will damage the insides of the mouth and or tongue. So they have to definitely
they have
be
to grind
gone
those
up.
Down.
Yes.
Okay.
And some people still float. That's a rasp in there by hand, and other people have like a little chainsaw. It's a paper and where the chain would be, and that sands everything down. And it depends on the type of horse, and my horse will let you do it without being tranquilized. Not all horses will.
Well, not unlike humans with sedation dentistry.
Exactly.
So there you go.
You know, we all have... Humans are frightened and fight. Horses are frightened and fly. So if you're fighting with somebody in your mouth and you're frightened about it, you're going to try and get away.
There is a certain sophistication to the horse.
Yes.
As an animal, unlike some of the other animals that we've seen, not to take away from what the exhibitors have done with some of the other species, but this is different. This is very special.
And it is. And you can develop this camaraderie between you and your horse.
Yeah, a little different than with a goat or a pig.
Somebody says, oh, my horse come to me. And I say, yes, if you teach it. Oh, no. Well, my horse, if I whistle out loud wherever he is and say, come, it's nice that he comes running.
Yeah, so they get to know your voice and your temperament, and obviously your facial expression.
Yes.
And who you are. And
it's nice when they nicker to you when you come in the barn and you haven't even spoke yet. But this horse knows my truck.
Yeah.
He'll come to the edge of the fence and watch me come in. And those are little things that you take the time to do.
And these horses are being judged today by a very vetted judge, Duke Digert. And
yes.
He's looking now. So this is in the Senior English Pleasure. We had two splits. This is the best of split one and split two that are back in the ring and the arena. And of those entrants, we're looking for the top in this particular division.
Yes, and I think they've been pinning five, and right now he's just making sure his numbers are straight.
He wants to make sure, and that's what we've seen in some of the other areas of judging. Right, his assistant is going over to Kirby Digert with the list. Let's see.
And
what
it's nice
got.
What he does. He's talking to a couple people about a couple things, and it's very nice to have a positive feedback.
Yeah, you can see that. He's talking with the exhibitors from all over Western New York. I'm not going to go through the names because I'm going to miss one.
This is true.
And I don't want to do that out of respect for the families who are watching.
Well, and Mr. Degert's so tall, and as you said, he could be on TV. He just could talk to somebody on a horseback and be right there, you know? He's not...
Here we go.
In your Senior English Pleasure, coming in fifth place will be back number 250, Jillian Buckert of Lancaster, New York, with ABD Jake of Diamonds. Fourth place will come to back number 119, Aaron Hayes of Holland, New York, with Song and a Prayer.
Oh, that's good. She's a... Up Orleans.
Third place in your Senior English Pleasure is going to go to back number 214, Brianna Warner of Frewsburg, New York, with the Flashy Invitation. Second place in your Senior English Pleasure is going to go to back number 125, Gabrielle Marchetti of Lockport, New York, with Potential Chocolate. And first place in your Senior English Pleasure, go to back number 60, Samantha Logan of Eden, New York, with Who's Perfect? Congratulations to all the riders in our Senior English Pleasure. At this time, we'll take a lunch break and return back here at 12:45. 12:45, we'll start back here in the ring with Junior English Pleasure.
All right, Larry Thurber, we're going to take a short break. We'll be back in a few minutes. We want to make congratulations, Samantha Logan of Eden, New York, number one with Who's Perfect in that perfect division. All right, and we're back in just a little bit. So we're going to take a break on the Ustream for lunch. You take a lunch break too, and we'll be back from the Showplex in Hamburg, New York, the Erie County Fairgrounds.